Dear John, Daniel, and Nectaria, thank you very much for having me here in my capacity as a non-executive director to EcomBX. I will be super fast as the services we provide. I'm very sorry that I heard no one talking about digitalization in the banking sector and the benefits that comes out of this for the economy. I'm very well aware that digitalization is a priority for the government of Kyriakos Mitsotakis. So, for years, the banking sector has invested a lot in their online services, but due to COVID-19, this effort is reinforced and it looks like this is going to continue in the future. Except the big retail banks, there is a new industry developing at the moment that can support the banking sector and improve the services provided to customers. This new industry is called FinTech. This will revolutionize the way we do banking. FinTech is the new technology that is automating the delivery and use of financial services. Customers can better manage their operations even through their own smartphone. Banking and the financial markets will not only restore the confidence through the development of new technologies, but will also gain new customers as it will be more accessible and user-friendly to do banking. This is one of the reasons that the European Central Bank is providing a new type of license that is called FinTech Banking License, that it takes into consideration the new technologies that can be brought into the financial system. The digitalization of banking and financial services is going to lead in a more transparent, easy to use, and accessible environment. In the near future, we will even have reduced NPLs. We were talking before about NPLs, due to the online processes and algorithms that will be used in order for a bank to provide a loan. On top of that, it is going to be faster and more efficient. That's why lately we see more and more people, and especially the youngs, leaving the traditional banks in order to become customers to the new age digital banks. We now have neobanks as well. These are fintechs that do not hold a banking license of their own, but they count on bank partners to provide bank license services. Payments, money transfers, money lending, and more are provided by these neobanks. In one of the latest MasterCard surveys on new payments, a majority of consumers polled said that they are willing to consider cashless methods such as digital or mobile wallets, QR codes, and even cryptocurrencies that no one is talking about today about this. This survey was conducted across 18 markets globally. MasterCard also says, points out that 90% of the consumers have tried at least one emerging payment type in the last year. And out of those, two-thirds of them have actually done it for the first time. So you can imagine what is coming in the very near future. The new type of banks will be consumer-centric, providing personalized services that are backed up by technology and data-driven decisions. This will lead to a stronger financial system and will provide alternative ways to finance growth. Thank you very much.